From the hallowed grounds of Fenway Park, we've got baseball on the show. It's the Cleveland Guardians and the Boston Red Sox. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Coming up on the first pitch, and on the mound in this one, Cooper Criswell. Chris, how about a scouting report?
Well, most pitchers today are pretty tall, but this guy's definitely taller than most. He's kind of an imposing figure out there, especially when he's standing on top of the bump. It's like he's looking down on you, so hitters have to be prepared for a couple of things. Ball can get on you a lot quicker because of the extension and release point, and then also tilt through the zone. If you're going to try to hit pitches at the bottom of the zone, it's going to be difficult to get on plane. So look for something up from this guy. You might have a chance to do some damage.
And a ball and two strikes. And that one almost hit him. Swing and a ground ball out to short. One out in the top of the first. Here's the Guardians lineup now. They're facing a pitcher today who's prone to giving up homers, so we'll see. We might get some big swings here today.
Yeah, I think the key, though, and the reason why he gives up those homers is that guys are locking in, they're aggressive, and they have a high confidence level. So I think if that's the approach these hitters take with the stuff he's got there on the mound, yeah, there's a good chance that there'll be some balls that fly a long way. But you can't get too big in your swing, otherwise you'll be really frustrated after this one.
Rafaela has a bead on it. He's got it, and there's two away.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
The third baseman.
Two outs, base is empty. Jose Ramirez digs in for the Guardians. Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Righty delivers. Swing and he breaks his bat. McGuire to first in time. They don't come much closer than that. Bang, bang, play to end the inning. Cleveland nothing. Sox coming to bat. You're dialed into the show. Back here at Fenway, and today's starter, Carlos Carrasco. How about a scouting report on him?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
And a foul ball.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
Fly ball to right. Laureano settles under it and puts the squeeze on that one. One up, one down. As we check out the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. And now the center fielder, Zidane Rafaela. One out, base is empty. Just missed. Fouls one off, 2-2.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
One down, base is empty. Battling here as he fouls it away. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. Now it's the DH, Masataka Yoshida. That one off the mark, and a count 2-1. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
And he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Two outs. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. At the belt and fires. High fly ball out towards left field. Juan moving back. And it hits off the monster. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Just about got it out of here down the line to left. So I'm sure he wishes he could have put a little more behind it, but he's got to feel good about that missile off the wall.
And it's Rafael Devers in the box. The 1-1. And a foul ball.
Well, here's a chance right here for one of the better hitters on this roster to get him on the board in the first. Thanks to the three-hole hitter extending the inning. Good at bat with two outs.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Yoshida at second with two down. On the ground at first, Naylor. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. On to the second from Fenway Park. No score. Back inside Fenway Park, top of the second. So in now for Cleveland, Josh Naylor. And the pitch. Hit hard, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Here's Ramon Laureano. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Gets the slider in there for a strike. Ed Drummond behind the plate calling balls and strikes. Maybe one of the most respected umpires around the league.
He's not the kind of umpire that you're likely to notice back there. And that can be a huge compliment, really. So if you're just kind of quietly doing your job, staying consistent with your calls, hitters, pitchers, managers, even fans, they're all going to appreciate you. Ed Drummond, he's that kind of umpire.
Nabs it. Naylor at the plate now.
The catcher. So
man at first, one away. Next pitch is downstairs. And there's a foul ball. And the righty deals. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Left-hand batter waits. On the ground right side. 4-6-3. It's a double play. And that'll do it for the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Now to the bottom of the second. We're tied. Nothing-nothing. We head to the bottom of the second. Now batting Tristan Casas.
The first baseman, Tristan Casas.
One now. Lifted in the air, right center field. Settles under this one. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
Batting six, the second baseman, Emmanuel.
Here's the second baseman. And that's off the inside edge. And it's 3-2. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
Here's Tyler O'Neill. Tosses to first, and O'Neill is retired. That ends the inning. Nothing doing for Boston. We'll move to the third with no score. On to the third inning. And now, Will Brennan.
Will Brennan.
Next offering is in for a strike. Righty to the plate. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One, two now. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The line of the pitch. Chases that one out of the zone. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike pitch right there. At worst-case scenario, it's weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
Here's Tyler Freeman to hit. One down, base is empty. On the ground to short, Story. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Batting none. The shortstop, Brian.
Here's Brian Rocchio. Two down, nobody on. Up the middle. Oh, he gloves it over to first. And they get the out.
That was a great job of doing the math. He had the perfect angle. Diving stop completes the play. And that ends the inning.
And we're back here at Fenway Park. Here's Reese McGuire.
The catcher. Reese McGuire.
The pitch. Line drive, and it goes just foul. Two now. Bounces over the wall and foul ground. It's an automatic double.
Well, this tends to happen more often in this park than others, and that short fence is just so inviting for hitters. You see a lot of balls bounce over for an automatic double when no one can run it down.
Here's Trevor Story. Fouled off, 2-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. McGuire leads off second with nobody out. The next pitch misses, and the count's full. Goes down looking.
The right fielder, number
now batting 15. Jaren Duran. Feels like it's less common today that you see a guy like this. The speed component, the contact component, but lack of power.
He just has to understand that his skill set is unique and he's very valuable for any ball club. If he does that, he'll play a long time in this league.
That's out to center field. Freeman racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, center fielder, today, Rafaela.
Zidane Rafaela up next for the Red Sox. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. McGuire coming home. The throw into second, not in time. He's safe as they jump ahead and run scores.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the ball straight to it. That's great work right there.
Next is the designated hitter, Masataka Yoshida. Kicks and fires. That one fouled off. Now, Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Got him looking. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. Three innings complete. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Guardians nothing. Here at Fenway as we go to the top of the fourth. Here's the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Story sends it over to first, and one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
The second baseman, Andres Jimenez.
Here's Andres Jimenez. The Guardians trailing by a run, top half of inning number 4. And that's another ball.
You got two balls, one strike.
And he grounds one to the right side. And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. One down, base is empty. Headed towards the corner. And it stays fair. And now the tying run is into scoring position.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
One out, runner at second. Now it's Jose Ramirez. And the right-hander deals. Next offering misses down and away.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit is probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
The pitch. That three one ball, in the dirt, one, and now 3-1.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count, be ready to turn on a fastball.
The 3-1. That's a slider for a strike.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Now this one's crushed down the line. Looking. Foul ball. Ripped to short. And Ramirez is set down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but a competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
And now it's Josh Naylor. The pitch. Just missed.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position. And a hitter's count.
Ramon Laureano to bat next. That one out to right. Long run. Pulls it in on the run. And that is that. Guardians lead one. And it remains 1-0. Back now at Fenway. John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Rafael Devers. And a pitch. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. And it's a one-hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. And that's a leadoff double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
So stepping in for Boston, Tristan Casas. Kicks and deals. Popped up. Settles underneath it. And it's caught for the out.
Now batting, the second baseman, Edmanuel Valdez.
Now it's the second baseman. Swing and a miss.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And another ball. Devers over at second, one down. On the ground, right side. Jimenez throw to first. Two gone now.
Now batter, left fielder, Tyler.
So two down now, and here is Tyler O'Neill. And delivers outside. That one a little bit high, and that's ball three. Reese McGuire waiting to bat for the Red Sox. Runner at third, two away. Hard hit left side. Toss to Naylor, out with room to spare, and that's the inning. And the Red Sox lead one, but they still lead it 1-0. Back here at Fenway Park, we go to the top of the fifth. Laureano comes up to hit. Here's a 1-1. There's the strike of the knees.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
One, two now. Stays alive. ground ball up the middle. On the run, throw to first. Throw is low, and he can't pick it.
It doesn't really matter where you are in the lineup. Your job is to get on base and try to start a rally if you're leading off an inning. So an infield single does the job right there. Now we'll see if they can make something happen.
Now at the plate, Bo Naylor. And a count 1-2.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
The 1-2. That's inside. Nobody out. Runner at first. That one is absolutely belted. Rafaela on the move, racing back. And he brings it in on the warning track. Will Brennan digs in for the Guardians.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
And he deals. On the ground to third. Devers tossed the second, and that's two.
Poetry in motion there as the second baseman turns the double play. Nice throw to first, and that's the way to end the inning.
Bottom of the inning, and now the catcher comes up to him, Reese McGuire. The pitch. It's center field. So a man on base to start the inning.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. I can watch base hits like that one all day long, and so can every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Trevor Story now. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The shortstop takes the ball. Movement in the bullpen. Hunter Gaddis, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Beattie getting loose as well. McGuire, the board here at first with nobody out. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Oh, that high four-seam fastball has become such a staple as a strikeout pitch over the years. And what's so tough as a hitter is that you see it extremely well. The problem is the velocity and spin rate just happens to jump by you. You expand your zone, you don't stay tall on the backside, and you're really not even able to make contact. If you do, many times it's a pop-up.
Now here is Jarren Duran. And another ball. Two and one now. Runner on the move. Fouls one off. 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
His eyes got big. He saw that changeup way out in front. Better to pull it than to get jammed on something off speed like that.
That one missed. And ball four to aboard.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Carlos Carrasco is done in this one, and he leaves in a one-run game. New pitcher coming up. We'll be back in a minute. Hunter Gaddis gets the ball now.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
First and second, one out. And next for the Red Sox, Sedane Rafaela. To right. Laureano trying to get there. He's got it. Runner tags up for third, and he moves up a base. So two away with runners at the corners.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Masataka.
Now here's the Red Sox DH, Masataka Yoshida. The pitch swings through that one.
Well, a come and get me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
Runners on first and third, two away. Last half of inning number five. Fights that one away, still one and two. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Huge strikeout there.
He's in a tough spot. Had to make a great pitch. Did it. Got the strikeout. Gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
And we're back. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. And the batter now, Tyler Freeman. Here's a 1-1. Wouldn't chase that time. But why to kick the pitch? In the dirt, 3-1.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
And he walked him.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
No outs. Runner at first. Stepping up for the Guardians, Brian Rocchio. With the go-ahead run at the plate. And we're in the top half of the sixth. Just missed. Stephen Kwan in the on deck circle. Swings and misses. And a full count now.
Well, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see. And he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
There's one. He's out. And they get him easily at first. It's a double play.
As a former player, watching 5-4-3 double plays brings back some adrenaline. It's such an exciting play, and it's always a great reminder of baseball being such a team sport.
Stephen Kwan digs in for the Guardians. Not even close there. Yeah, that's ball two. Two outs, base is empty. That one misses in the dirt. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. The wind of the pitch. On the ground to third. And that is the inning. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Guardians nothing. Back in Boston, leading Devers now.
For the Red Sox.
Yeah, and here's a fun stat on Devers. He's at his best when he's hitting homers and doubles. And by the time he was 26 years old, Devers already had over 150 home runs and more than 200 doubles. He's just the 15th player in baseball history with those kinds of numbers at that age.
The 1-2. That one just misses.
I don't know how you take that one after the called strike on the corner, just a little bit off the edge.
Three. Struck him out looking. Clipped the bottom of the zone with a curve for strike three.
No, you know that's got to be very frustrating for this guy. He knows the strike zone extremely well. And you know what? Good hitters are not going to compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
And stepping in for Boston, Tristan Casas. Takes it himself. Two up, two down.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air. Maybe drive it into the gap.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the second baseman. The 1-1. And another ball. Clips the outside corner. 2-2 now. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down. 1-2-3. Red Sox go down quietly. They lead it 1-0. Top of inning number 7. And now Andrés Giménez.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Pitch in the dirt. 2-1. And downstairs. Boston's bullpen with some activity. Joely Rodriguez, the left-hander, up and throwing. Jansen, the right-hander, also getting loose. And the pitch. Splits the plate. Full count ball.
Oh, I'm impressed with that challenge pitch right there. Even with this slim lead, this guy's not afraid to go right after these hitters.
Got him looking. And one away. A big first out here in the 7th via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, it's so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Here's Jose Ramirez. In the air to left center. O'Neill getting an angle on it. He's got it. And there's two down.
The first baseman, number 22, Josh.
Here's Josh Naylor. Here's a 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Trying to hold a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number 7. Bounce to the right side. Whips it to Casas. Third out, and that ends the frame. Guardians go down 1-2-3. They're down 1-0. Set for the last half of the 7th. Now the left fielder, Tyler O'Neill.
Tyler O'Neill.
The 1-1. And there's a hit.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. You'll often hear the phrase, short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive in the center field.
And another ball. O'Neill gets his lead at first. Nobody out.
That's ball three.
This one in the dirt. To second, but way too late. Safe there. And that's a wild pitch as he moves into scoring position.
Definitely trying to work down and get that double play ball, but it got away enough to erase any chance of that. Good job of moving up in the scoring position. Now a hit could make that wild pitch really sting.
That one finds the zone, and the count's full. Got it by him for the K.
Pretty nasty cutter right there, and you're seeing that pitch, that location, a lot more these days, and you can see why. Very difficult for hitters. I think the great Mariano Rivera can at least partially be credited for that, thanks to the career he had with the cutter. It was just dominant. I tell you what, I felt like it was a moral victory whenever I could put that pitch in play. So I can feel for the guy right there walking back to the dugout.
One out and a runner at second near the bottom of the seventh. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
Two balls, two strikes.
Good job to fight that one off. Man at second. And there's a ball. And that's ball four. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this. But he's going to have to buckle down right here.
One out. Runners at first and second.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play move.
This one in the air center field. Freeman on his way over. Drops into the glove. Runner tags at second, and he moves up to third. Now two away. Sidane Rafaela up next for the Red Sox.
Today, Rafaela.
And here it comes. Right field down the line, and that one slices foul. Runners on first and third, two away. Two on, two outs. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. Boston strands a pair, but they lead it 1-0. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Joely Rodriguez.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Leading well, for the one-run game. So in now for Cleveland, Ramon Laureano.
Laureano.
The pitch.
Two balls, one.
Action in the pen down there. Chris Martin, the closer of the staff, is throwing. The pitch. That one misses. And that's ball three. Bone Naylor on deck for the Guardians. Three-one now. And that's through there for a strike. This one bashed to left center. On its way, and that one's out of here. He powers that one out of here. And we are tied. It's 1-1.
This game is breathing new life thanks to that home run, and that's exactly what they needed. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. Here's the catcher, Bo Naylor, at the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer. Will Brennan, the next to hit.
A little surprised we don't see a pinch hitter here with the lefty-lefty matchup.
On the ground to third. Fires across the diamond and two away now.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Tyler.
Here's the center fielder, Tyler Freeman. Two down, base is empty, but one run across, and we're at the top of the eighth. Close, but called a ball. And it's 2-1.
It's getting squeezed a little bit here late.
Two outs. Freeman hits it in the air, and that'll fall for a base hit.
Now batter.
Two outs, runner at first. And up next for Cleveland, Brian Rocchio. And a count 1-2.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
That's ripped into the outfield. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Solo shot for the Guardians this inning. All even now at 1-1. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the eighth, Joe stepping in for Boston, Masataka Yoshida. The 1-1. In the air, right field. Laureano settles under it. Calls it in, and there's one away.
The batter, the third baseman.
And here is Devers.
He's a big, strong guy, can untie this game with one swing.
One down, base is empty. Swings and misses. And it's 1-2.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
That just misses. Ball two.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
And he chases that one. That's the second out. Tristan Casas up next for the Red Sox. All tied up here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. That one fouled off, 2-2. And a pitch. And that's outside. Number 47 on deck for Boston. hit pretty well in the air out to center. Freeman in position. Hauls it in to end the inning. It's the ninth, and we are tied. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Josh Winkowski. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Here's the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Backed off the plate that time. In the air, left side. O'Neill getting an angle on it. And there's one away.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit. And then from there can really settle in.
And a good eye there. The Red Sox with some bullpen action. Isaiah Campbell getting loose out there. Base is empty, one away here at the top of the ninth. Swung on, belted. Duran ranging back. Gone. And that's how they take the lead. It's 2-1.
Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
And now it's switch hitting third baseman Jose Ramirez. And the righty deals. Next pitch in for a strike at about 1-2.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
One down, base is empty. Swings and misses, it's a strikeout. Snuck the fastball by him. So next will be the four-hole hitter for the Guardians, Josh Naylor. Two down, nobody on. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Ramon Laureano digs in for the Guardians. Two outs. And misses inside.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. And down on strikes he goes. And that'll do it. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emmanuel Clase.
Power slider guy, Boog. He throws it hard and gets a lot of late movement, so it's tough to pick up.
Well, one run game. Now it's the second baseman.
The second baseman. Edmund Ware. Ball down.
Next offering is in for a strike. On the ground, out to short. One out, bottom of the ninth.
If you want to be a great defense, you have to deliver consistently. It doesn't matter how many highlight reel plays you make if you can't execute the small stuff, just like we saw.
Tyler O'Neill will hit next. That one ripped, but foul. A one-run lead. Yeah, the home team trying to pull it out. Ripped to the right center. Should be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. Here comes the throw, and the tying runs at second base with a double.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Really important at-bat coming up now.
Here's the catcher to hit, Reese McGuire. So the tying run at second. And a count one and two.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. I mean, you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it. But this is where they earn their keep.
Right-hander kicks, deals. On its way to the corner. Drifts towards it. And that drops foul. The middle, and they're down to their last out.
Those plays can be tricky. They're routine, but that doesn't mean it's always going to be smooth. She delivered a good play right there.
Trevor Story comes up to the plate. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list.
Yeah, we go beyond just the fielding percentage and what it looks like, but the ability to have range and close holes that are normally there against an average.
Right side, hard hit. Throw to first, ball game, and the Guardians strand the tying run on base to win it.
Well, you take a tie ball game into the ninth on the road, you know that you've got some work to do. You got to score, but then you've also got to get three outs in the bottom half of that inning. They did just that today. Very well played ball game. Get this win on the road. Everybody's happy with the W.
And your final score here today, 2-1 for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game. First, for the victorious Cleveland Guardians, 2 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 runners on base.